the hallmarks of enzyme-catalyzed reactions are their remarkable speed and selectivity. Another name for selectivity is substrate specificity, and we'll deal with that in a few webcasts. What I want to do here is to give you some intuitive feeling for just how fast enzyme-catalyzed processes can be. One of the ways that we benchmark rates of catalyzed versus uncatalyzed reactions is by looking at the ratio of the rate coefficients. K-cat represents the rate coefficient in the presence of the catalyst, and K-uncat represents the background rate of the reaction, the rate coefficient in the absence of the catalyst. For enzymes, these numbers, the rates and rate enhancements, can be on the order of a millionfold, but typically they're much larger than that and can even be as large as 100 billion. I'll give you some intuitive feeling for what these numbers mean and the kinds of timescale changes that come about because of catalysis on the next slide. But first, let me give you an example of a reaction that's carried out under different conditions, one of which is an enzyme-catalyzed process. So the reaction is a substitution reaction on a glucose derivative. It's a substitution reaction that involves replacing this phenoxide group with this hydroxide group. It can be carried out under specific acid-catalyzed conditions. It can be carried out under general acid-catalyzed conditions where the proton is delivered from an intramolecular source, or it can be conducted by the enzyme beta-galactosidase. We'll look at the rate coefficients over here, but first let me just give you briefly an outline of the mechanism. I won't give you all the details, but the mechanism involves, as you might guess, first, protonation of the oxygen on the phenoxide group. That makes it a better leaving group, and followed by a beta elimination of that group to make an oxocarbenium ion intermediate. The oxocarbenium ion is an electrophile. It's then captured by the nucleophilic water. There's a proton transfer that takes place, and the phenoxide is replaced by the hydroxide. For the first process, we're going to conduct this reaction in the presence of a constant amount of acid. Actually, this reaction is almost immeasurably slow in the absence of any kind of acid source. So we'll conduct the reaction in the presence of an acid. We'll keep the concentration of acid constant at 0.1 normal, and when we measure the rate coefficient under those conditions, we find that it's a pseudo first order rate that has a reaction rate constant of about 2 times 10 to the minus 6th per second. In the next case, as I mentioned, we have the intramolecular delivery of a proton, and this is probably a general acid catalyzed process. The key thing is it's the close proximity of this proton to the base, the oxygen that needs to be protonated, that makes for such a high, what we call effective molarity of protons. We don't have a very high concentration of protons per se in terms of the normal way that it's measured, but in terms of a proximity, because this proton can never leave the vicinity of that base, its effective concentration is very high. And again, the key word that you might want to write down is effective molarity. The effective molarity is very high, and because of that, this intramolecular delivery of a proton accelerates the reaction almost a thousandfold. The key thing, and we'll talk about this in more detail in an upcoming webcast, is this idea of proximity effect, and that that proton is nearby where it has to be in order to carry out the reaction. So we've seen a thousandfold acceleration. What about the reaction when it's catalyzed by the enzyme beta-galactosidase? In this case, we see almost 2 million-fold enhancement relative to the reaction that's conducted just in the presence of 0.1 normal HCl. And so clearly, the enzyme-catalyzed process can be very fast. We're looking at catalyzed processes, so we're actually not comparing K-cat to K-uncat. But even so, you can see accelerations that are more than a million-fold. What does it mean to be a million-fold enhancement in reaction rate? This slide summarizes several different enzymes, each of the different enzymes that are involved in things like metabolism or the production of nucleic acids. They're shown here in the boxes. And along this axis is a time scale, and it's logarithmic. And so you can see that at the very bottom we have a time scale that represents a half-life, how long the substrate lives, 50% of it, measured in terms at the very bottom of the age of the Earth. So This particular enzyme, ODC, which catalyzes a generation of a nucleic acid derivative, is going to be immeasurably slow in the absence of the enzyme. But the enzyme can accelerate it almost by 100 billion fold, and so that now, on the time scale of 1 second, it becomes a measurably fast and quite relevant reaction from a biologically useful standpoint. And you can see that other uncatalyzed rates follow similarly, but some of them can be quite fast. Nonetheless, they all achieve some amounts of acceleration, and in the catalyzed form are, as I said, a millionfold or up to 100 billionfold times as fast. So that hopefully gives you, especially when you consider these timescales over here, an idea of just how much enhancement in rate one can expect to achieve from an enzyme-catalyzed process.